curve, let's say the fifth root of 1 plus t, I could use 1 plus x, but I'm using 1 plus t, is less than or equal to 1 plus t over 5 for all t greater than or equal to 0. That's something I happen to know is true. Let's confirm it graphically. So I will graph both of these functions here as functions of x. 1 plus x to the 1/5 power or 0.2 power. And also, I meant to put that in y1. Also 1 plus x over 5. Plot it for values of x greater than or equal to 0. I'll let x go from 0 to 10. Okay, so first it's going to graph the fifth root one, and then it's going to graph the linear function. There's the fifth root. It is a curve. It's concave down. And then the linear functions right there, you can see that inequality is definitely true. This graph is below that graph. Though it does look like they're maybe equal when t is 0. And in fact, yes, they are. If you plug in t equals 0, here you get fifth root of 1, which is 1. Plug in t equals 0 here, you get 1 plus 0, which is 1. But how do you prove this? You could say, let A equals 0 and B be some positive number unspecified. Let G of T, the slower horse, be the fifth root function. Fifth root of 1 plus t, which is the same as 1 plus t to the 1/5. By the way, what I'm showing you here, I have put on exams in the past, typically with some help. And h of t be the linear function. I'm trying to set myself up to be able to use the racetrack principle. I'm trying to show g of t is always less than or equal to h of t, which is the conclusion of that first bullet of the racetrack principle. Over the interval from a to b, where a is 0 and b is some unspecified positive number. And the fact that b is arbitrary, unspecified positive number, means that if I can do it over the interval from a to b, it'll be true for all t greater than or equal to 0, because b is arbitrary positive number. I'm not saying what it is. We should say some things. We should make sure all the hypotheses of the racetrack principle are satisfied. Are G and H continuous and differentiable? Yeah, they are. We know that. Certainly H is. It's a linear function. Is G? Yes, it is continuous and differentiable as long as T is greater than negative 1. It's actually continuous everywhere, but fails to be differentiable at negative 1. Its graph, if you graph it over the entire real number line, looks about like... It's got a vertical tangent at this point. That point is negative 1, 0. That's the graph of g of t. But we're only concerned about when t is greater than or equal to 0, so we don't have to worry about that part. We can say we know g and h are both continuous on the interval from A to B, where A is 0 and B is some arbitrary positive number, and differentiable on the open interval from A to B, where A is 0 and B is some arbitrary positive number. Also, G of A, which is g of 0 equals the fifth root of 1 is 1, and h of a equals h of 0 equals 1 plus 0 over 5 is also 1. These horses are starting at the same place at the same time. Therefore, the racetrack principle RTP implies g of t is less than or equal to h of t for all t in the interval from 0 to b. And again, since b is arbitrary, this implies that this inequality is true for all t greater than or equal to 0. This is since b is arbitrary. You know, b could be 1, it could be 10, it could be a million, it could be a billion, it could be a Google, it doesn't matter. It's true over the interval there, so it's got to be true for all positive t. And that means we're done. This means we're done because g of t is the fifth root of 1 plus t, and h of t is 1 plus t over 5. I finished it. QED, or praise the Lord, PTL.